This is day one of the motorhome swap. Got two motorhomes here. This is my 1985 Southwind by Fleetwood that I've been living in and fixed the whole interior up on. This is the running Southwind Fleetwood that I just got today. I'm gonna go around here. Here we see Liz. Sorry, Liz.
Hi.
Removing some of the crazy built-in gothic looking bed that I have here in the living area. Record this part of this update here, but we're still doing this RV interior swap thing or whatever. And as you can see, we got the floor, the laminate floor that was in here was kind of cheap one. We got it off the floor, and we got the sheetrock off the ceiling. And now we're just kind of reframing this barrier wall between the cab and the living room. This is the poor wall off the other my other motorhome. The brown wall. Right, in pieces, and we put it up here, and then we're gonna go wall by wall till we get to the back. So. Swap project, and I am recording video. Anyway, I'm here in the old RV, the donor RV, I should call it, and you can see the wall is gone. It's been moved to the new one, and I'm starting the second wall here. This is the second wall I'm going to start, the wall where the window is covered up. It's my wall the TV goes on, as well as the fireplace. It's the only solid wall, really. And so I'm gonna try to transplant this wall as intact as possible as I can over to the RV, electrical and all. So let's see what. Next was to demolish the kitchen and move the kitchen from the other RV over, including the cabinets, countertop, and appliances. And installing the electric water heater. This took us about 2 days to complete. Next step was to add the recessed lights and the wiring for the recessed lights in the living room. At this point, we were about halfway done with the first phase of remodeling and finishing the details on all the interior walls that were not intact.
It was at this point that the transmission in the motorhome gave out, and I had to stop everything on the inside to transplant the transmission from the old RV over to the new motorhome. This took about 4 days of hard work to make the transition. Now with the transmission installed, we resumed our work on the interior transformation of the new motorhome. To make it easier to transplant stuff from one motorhome to the other, we created this bridge between the doors one night. It was much easier, considering the weather had begun to get colder, to transport stuff back and forth while I prepared for painting. After discovering that the front partition wall was not going to work for this current situation, it was demolished and we constructed a new smaller wall with bifold accordion doors on each side to enter the cab from the main living area. Using the bifold accordion doors allowed us not only to block the entire cab off from the living area, but allow during driving times the doors to be opened and the seats to be reclined or moved back to a more comfortable position. Now with all the changes that have been made, it was time to repaint again. The accent walls needed to be moved to a different adjoining wall, and a nice new fresh coat of paint was in order after all the work that had been done. I also briefly decided to change the exterior color theme to black and white, but as it looked like a prison bus, I dumped that idea quickly after and went back to the original tan exterior. The color scheme is about the same and is really simple. A dark chocolate type paint on the accent walls, and for the main color, an ice mocha. The new living room was done, at least for the time being, and it was beautiful. Functioned much better, looked much better, and really had a nice appeal to it. But it wasn't quite what I was looking for exactly, I found out. And there's more changes to come. I now turn my attention to the rear of the motorhome, to the bedroom and bathroom area. The floor needed to be put down, the paint walls needed to be painted, and that back window, it just had to go. At this time, I also removed the internal water tank that was stored under the bed for repair as it was leaking onto the floor below. Once demolition was done, we had to allow for a couple days for the water on the floor to dry completely before I could texture, paint, and finish the walls. results were beautiful and well worth it. What a big change it made. At this point, you can consider the remodeling and transformation done, but not me. There's always something I would like to change and make improvements, and something doesn't work out. So I continued on after replacing the taillights with LED taillights, painting the exterior, and continuing to improve the interior again. I guess really I'll never be done. There'll always be a constant remodeling project in my home. It's the way I like it. Keeps me busy. And hey, there's nothing wrong with change. If it's for the better. Thanks to Liz for all her help in this remodeling. Couldn't have done it without her. She's been an incredible assistance to me in this stressful yet fun situation.